Hello everyone, thank you for joining us this morning and welcome to this webinar, WebRatio, the Comprehensive IFML Development Platform. I am Michela Frigerio from WebRatio and today I will be your host. The presentation will take 45 minutes and then we will have 50 minutes of question and answer. During the webinar, if you have any questions or technical issues, you can write them in the chat box that you have at the bottom right of your screen. And your question will be taken up in the question and answer session at the end of the webinar. We are also recording this session and we will email to you the link. Let me introduce the today's speakers. Daniel Pardhe is software architect for digital and mobile technologies at Cognizant, and Stefano Butti is the CEO and co-founder of WebRatio. The agenda of the today's session covers four topics. There will be an overview of the WebRatio platform, then Stefano will speak about some success stories in the banking and financial services industry and in the retail industry. And at the end, Stefano will present some of the cutting-edge technologies on which WebRatio is currently working on. Thank you once again for joining us this morning, and now over to Daniel and Stefano.
Thank you, Michela. That was great. So thank you once again for joining us, everyone. We welcome you, and this is a great session. We have Stefano Butti, as you heard, the CEO and co-founder of WebRatio. And Stefano, would you want to say a word before we go into the meat of the program?
Yes, sure. I'm very happy to be here. So welcome to everybody, and I'm very glad to talk with you today.
So, Stefano, let's jump into the session. We have a very good audience here representing the banking and financial as well as retail industry. And they are very keen to understand what this WebRatio platform is. And I have written a couple of blogs on IFML and the comprehensive implementation. So how does WebRatio bring these open specifications of UML, BPM, and IFML together under one platform, and what is the relationship? And if you can speak a little more about the relationship between this open visual modeling specification and WebRatio platform, that would be great.
Sure. First of all, let's talk about WebRatio and how WebRatio is linked with IFML. So the basic idea behind WebRatio is to exploit the IFML visual specification to let user edit a model of the application they want to build. So we offer a visual editor that lets you define the application by writing a visual code and not by coding. Then we attach to the model a code generation engine. So one half of WebRatio is the editor and the other half is a very, very efficient code generation engine. The code generation builds a platform-independent code, so the code is generated is open. It is based on Java technologies and JavaScript, HTML5, and so there is no proprietary runtime in sight, and it can be executed on any Java standard environment. And we address especially the user layer, user interface layer. So we use IFML for generating both web and mobile application. So let's also see a very high level overview of the platform so that we understand how the platform works and how it is possible to automatically generate application. So first of all, let's talk about users. So WebRatio is targeted to different kinds of users. The first kind of user is what we define user interaction modeler. So this user is the user that uses the interaction flow modeling language that I hope you had the chance to know in the last webinar, in the first webinar of this series. The UI modeler define IFML models, and so that kind of express can define the application. The second kind of user is the business analysts. The business analysts work inside WebRatio platform by modeling business processes and modeling the data model. So many users can be both UI modeler and business analysts. So they are not exclusive each other, but a business analyst can really work only on business process modeling and start getting a web application starting from it. The third kind of user is the designer. So we do care a lot, and we will see later, we do care a lot about the layout, the graphic user interface, so that WebRatio can build really, really pretty applications. So despite being a code generation technology, applications generated by WebRatio have a very high quality user interface. This is possible, and that is possible because we allow a designer to work inside the platform to build layout and styles that are used by the code generation engine to build the final application. The fourth role is the programmer. So there is still space for programmers inside WebRatio platform. So there is no the platform is not only targeted not only exclusively to modelers. We know that a code generation technology cannot cover 100% of the needs. So we allow to extend WebRatio platform by programmers that can build integration components that allow application to interact with all the ecosystem of a company, both on premises or in the cloud. So once the design time is completed, then we can start the code generation. So we have a very efficient code generation engineer that addresses both the client side of the application and the server side of the application. Concerning the client side, we generate for the mobile environment using the PhoneGap Cordova framework. So we develop our own implementation of PhoneGap Cordova to be very efficient. So the mobile app can run on all the different platforms, iOS, Android, and we natively support the offline mode and data synchronization. The backend is generated using Java technologies, so the latest open source technology like Spring, Hibernate, and the runtime is based on open code. So as I said before, there is no proprietary code inside the backend. And then the backend can be connected to your information system. So we have built-in connector to any DBMS, built-in connector with ERP system like SAP, the IBM host, or cloud-based software like Salesforce and many others. We can connect to social networks, payment system. We can connect to the Internet of Things. So we will see it in the fourth of this webinar. And then you can connect generically with any of your IT asset.
Thank you, Stefano. That was a good introduction to the platform. So in summary, WebRatio is a technology that is bringing all this visual modeling, open specifications, OMG approved specifications to the table. And it does not eliminate the programmer altogether. It still requires a variety of users because these models basically represent different areas of development, and we need experts from each area of development to do the business process modeling, the interaction flow, as well as the classes in the UML models. So each area has been addressed inside the platform, and what is really nice is that it is completely open source. So the code that is generated can be later on owned by the user, and they can customize it, and if they were for any reason to discontinue the platform, they still have the complete source code with them. So this is in a nutshell of what the platform is about. So having put this platform together and having all these...
Yes, sorry, Daniel. Sorry, Daniel, to interrupt you. I can also add that the platform covers also web application development, so not only mobile. So the last part of the architecture is the generation of web technologies. Again, we do not have proprietary runtime here. We generate standard HTML5 responsive web application.
Thank you for that correction, Stefano. Yeah, we do not want the audience to think that this is exclusively mobile. Actually, it grew into mobile. It has been for web for almost 10-15 years. The platform is available and extensively used in production for the web. It's only recently when the mobile took form, the WebML specification actually was translated into IFML. Is that correct?
Yes, you're right. So, a little history of WebRatio. WebRatio started from the web domain in year 2001. So, at the beginning, the modeling language was called WebML. It was a modeling language that addressed only the web domain. In 2001, there were no mobile apps yet. And then we extended progressively the modeling language toward an abstract representation of any kind of user interaction, so both web, mobile, but also any kind of car or any other kind of human-machine interface. So the name changed from WebML to IFML when, as you remember in last webinar, the OMG decided to take WebML as a standard. So in the same time, WebML became IFML, and we extended the code generation platform from the web also to the mobile platform.
Thank you, Stefano. So that is the slight history of the WebML becoming IFML and OMG approving IFML as a language. And primarily the change happened because of the growth of mobility. And as you will see later in the session, the WebRatio team, who are also founders and inventors of IFML, they are also extending this into the Internet of Things and a lot more, as you will see later in this webinar. So to summarize this thing, we have seen the different users that will be using this platform. Would you also like to highlight what are the benefits that our esteemed audience can expect using this platform? What is the main theme of gains that they can expect to achieve out of this platform?
Yes, sure. We will see better these benefits in the success case that we will present in a few minutes. But we can divide the benefits in two main categories. One category is around the productivity. So having a code generation engine allow you to be very, very fast and to cut development costs even by 75 or 80%. We will see later real success cases. And being more productive means also being more agile. So cut the time to market. You are able to release your product in only a few weeks instead of months. And so you can also start developing even with uncertain requirements by adopting a full agile method. The second category of benefits are based on the fact that if you generate the code automatically, you can generate a very, very efficient code that is human error free, because it is generated automatically, and the code can be optimized to be very performant, very reliable, and very secure. So non-functional requirements like security, performance, and compliance can be automatically matched by using the code generation engine.
Right. So the biggest challenge we face in development is the distributed teams working across the globe and maintaining consistency in coding standards, best practices, security, performance, to bring all these teams on the same page. So this engine approach of auto-generating the code, we are building all these rules and consistencies in the platform itself. And so you will always get the same high quality code that it is programmed to, designed to generate. And so let us move to our conversation, to the practical use cases, because I hear a number of people say that, is this for real? Is this actually in production? This sounds like a great idea, but is this being used? And so that was one of the reasons why we arranged this three-part series. And for folks who did not join the part one, the videos are available where Professor Marco Brambilla, the inventor of IFML and also co-founder of WebRatio, explains the platform, the IFML specification. And today we will hear Stefano talk about some real-life scenarios and in production use cases, especially in the banking and the retail sector. So let us move our conversation to the success story, Stefano. If you can share with the audience where you have implemented and how you know it was done, that would be great.
Yes, sure. So let's start from some success story in the banking and financial services segment. I will talk here about two of our biggest customers. The first one is one of the major banks here in Europe. One, it is among the top 10 banks here in Europe. UniCredit is using WebRatio for managing different kind of systems. Some of them are represented here, so we are managing all the online leasing management systems that allow them to manage all the process required to answer to customer asking for leasing. So from the first offer to the final asset management. UniCredit is using WebRatio also for managing credit worthiness evaluation, customer credit worthiness evaluation, and also to manage information about yard, so to keep track of all the yard they finance through leasing. So we are talking here of very big application. So this is to say that WebRatio, okay, it addresses agile projects, very fast projects, so you can think about small projects, but here I present one of the biggest projects developed by WebRatio. The project here counts more than 11 million lines of code generated, and it counts 1,600 user interaction flow, so user interaction page. Let's say so. So it's a very big project, and this is to say that WebRatio, it can address project also in very big corporation like banking institution. The second example and the second customer I show here is GE Capital. GE Capital has used WebRatio for building different kind of application for managing their fleet management. So they built the integrated fleet management system showing being used by all the sales accounts of GE. This system allows to search for vehicles, to make business intelligence, cost analysis and performance analysis on the fleet, and this system is also offered to customers of GE Capital. So it's not only an internal dashboard for the sales account, but it is also it offers also a dashboard and a control panel to their customers. So this project is big, it counts 1 million lines of code, 500 user interactions, and it is used by more than 200,000 users. So, in the banking and financial institution industry, the benefits I would like to highlight, as I said at the beginning of this section is that WebRatio, thanks to its code generation, automatic code generation feature, is able to match compliance with the regulations. It is able to match security constraint and also performance needs. And let's talk a little bit about these 3 points. Let's talk about compliance. When building the application for GE Capital, we had to pass a test composed by 32 critical to quality tests. This was a standard inside GE Capital. So every application in GE Capital has to be compliant with these 32 tests, and we passed all these tests. So how it happens here, it doesn't happen by magic. So for being compliant to the GE Capital quality compliance, we make some adjustment inside our code generator. So if you remember the architecture picture, one of the 4 roles of WebRatio is the programmer. So the programmer is also able to change how the code is generated. So to make, for example, use different libraries, or it can be use different login and access control policies. So by adapting these generation rules to the correct libraries that are needed inside the companies, we are able to assure compliance to any kind of regulations. In this case, we generated an application that was perfectly compliant with the regulations of GE Capital. In the same time, we cut 75% of time and cost by building the application.
Thank you.
So, for example,
regulation,
yes,
part, Stefano, that was one of the key area which some of our audience was asking, was about the banking in Europe. I know is highly regulated, but here also in US is a very regulated industry. And so what you are highlighting here is that you have in production a fully a tested code for all the regulatory compliance as well as the security tests that you have in production. So just wanted to highlight that point because I think that is a significant and a very important point for our audience to understand.
Yes, yes, and the same history happened in UniCredit. So similarly to GE Capital, also UniCredit has many kind of regulations, both regulation imposed by the company, by the country, and also by the European institutions. So in UniCredit, we had to pass a very tough test about security, and WebRatio code successfully passed all the tests. They were 45 security tests concerning any kind of aspect about security, so denial of service attack, code injection, or also privacy issues there. So Europe is very careful about privacy. So all tests about the data to be protected or from incidental access. So the reason behind this. Success is again the code generation engine that can be adapted and adjusted in order to match the need. And the last example is again about GE Capital. So here we match performance need, and we succeeded in generating an application that was able to serve more than 200,000 users, and this was possible because the code generated by WebRatio is an open code, and that can be relied on, can be executed on any Java application server, and this means that you can adapt your own policy for scalability. So the application can be run in a distributed environment, so with a very high performance load balancer. All the code is thread safe, is safe all to be executed in also in a distributed cloud architecture. So we can build it on a elastic auto-scalable architecture so that you can address really, really high performances.
Great. So,
I can summarize.
Yeah, if you can summarize the banking, that would be great.
Yes, yes, Daniel. So let's summarize. We saw that in the banking and financial services industry, WebRatio is appreciated for the productivity and the agility, but most of all is appreciated by, because application generated by WebRatio can be compliant with the regulation of the BFS institution. They can match very high level of security, and they can be very, very they can afford very, very high performances.
Thank you, Stefano. I think we can move to the retail success story now.
Yes, yes. So let's talk about two other customers here. One is Acer Computer. This is one of the longest, one of the first customers we had in 2001. So this is an interesting story because it is a perfect example of the concept that you saw in the first webinar, that is, IFML is future-proof. What does it mean to be future-proof? It means that if you define a model of an interaction flow, a model of an application, the model lasts forever. And then the technologies can change every year, but then we take in charge the new technologies. The customer need only to invest his time in a model that lasts forever. So Acer Computer use WebRatio since 2001 to develop their public website worldwide, CMS, with a very, very tailored process of authoring and authorization process. It is using WebRatio also for managing all the web application, for managing the partner channel. And so they started using WebRatio in 2001. They built a lot of interaction flow model, and then they almost forget about any kind of technologies, because in 2001 we generated the cutting edge technologies of 2001, and in 2015 we are generating the cutting edge technologies of 2015, and we can assure you that in 2020 or 2030 we will generate the cutting edge technologies of 2020 and 2030. So the other customer I want to talk about is Measure Worldwide Furniture Producer. That it, I cannot disclose here, but I can say you that is a company based in Sweden that has many stores in many countries of the world, and that is worth almost 30 billion euros. They are using WebRatio for building many kind of application, addressing both customers and employees. For example, they are using WebRatio for managing trouble ticketing process, and also for managing cash reconciliation done at the end of each day. So we are talking about two big player in the retail industry, and again they are using WebRatio for managing big projects, so also critical projects customer-facing project, so that must be secure, scalable, and reliable.
So, Stefano,
yes.
Sorry to interrupt you. This you have this great implementations in production. Have you done any kind of study where you know there's an objective way of showing what was the productivity gain?
Yes. Sure. Acer Computer made this study for us. So we so the study was conducted by the customers. So it is an objective study, and the result is very very interesting. So I show here the result of this. There is a method for calculating the how big is an application that is called function point analysis. So that is more reliable than calculating the lines of code. So the function point is really a measure of how big is an application, and so you can measure the productivity of a team by calculating how many function points this team can build in a staff month. And the very interesting result that we get is that if you consider an average Java team, this team can build 16 points per staff month, while Acer Computer measured that their team, by using WebRatio technology, was able to build more than 130 function points per staff month. That means a productivity gain of 900%. And this is not only a spot. This result is replicated. Was replicated by another customer, completely independent from Acer. That is the way a system integrator here in Italy. They are an IFML certified company, and they calculated a productivity even better than the one of Acer. That is more almost 150 function points per month. This is an objective and real measure of how you can be fast and productive with WebRatio.
Great. I think that is astounding. The productivity gain is really huge, and having done an objective study, it really means a lot. We had this conversation before, and I think the audience would be also interested to know that yes, WebRatio is great, and they have done the cutting edge technology of today and yesterday. What does the roadmap of WebRatio look like for the future? They would be very keen to know that how you are planning or how you are keeping up with what's going on in the industry as of today. If you can elaborate a little on that.
Yes. So we are working off many of the current cutting-edge technologies. So because we want to keep the promise of future being future-proof. So I show you here three of the latest technologies that we are ready to support. The first one is the IoT, the IoT technology. So IoT is a very, very big segment. So I will show you how we work in the IoT segment. I will talk about our solution for building a proximity experience to customers. And I will talk also about another hot topic in this month, that is mobile payment. So on these three topics we are working. We are working both on the modeling language and also on the code generation engine to allow you to build application inside these three domains. So let's talk about IoT. As you know, IoT is a big set of technologies. So as you may imagine, we address the user interaction layer to the IoT world. So we position our platform at the high level of the stack. So if we can imagine that at the bottom there are the sensors, so the hardware, then there is the infrastructure and the network, then there is the layer that collects data from the IoT world, and then we sit just on top of the data. So with WebRatio and IFML, you can easily and very quickly build IoT dashboards and control panels that allow you to read data and also to interact with the things, both using a web and mobile. Web and a mobile device. So we are already building applications that interact with things like, for example, vending machine or coffee machine or refrigerator, for example. And we are also using WebRatio for building dashboard to show data about people counter, temperature sensor, physical sensor, energy sensor, and any kind of sensor. And we are also working in the industrial internet. So as you saw in the first webinar, IFML is considered by the Industrial Internet Consortium the standard to manage the interaction layer of industrial internet applications. So we are allowing to use WebRatio for industrial internet application.
The second topic, yes. Last topic, Stefano, IoT in itself, probably we should have another webinar fully dedicated to IoT.
Yes, actually, I think so.
Some folks in Cognizant, we have a special unit for IoT, and I'm speaking with them if they can, you know, get engaged, and we can have Professor Marco or, you know, somebody from your team explain the applications of IFML with IoT and how WebRatio implements the IFML.
Yes. I think too that it would be a good idea to organize a new dedicated webinar to IoT, because we see that the IoT domain is exploding. So there are we are finding many customers wanting to start proof of concept. So WebRatio is very suitable for building proof of concept in the IoT domain, because it can let you very quickly get a minimum viable product to show you the benefits of maybe introducing IoT technologies. So for example, I talked before about coffee machine. One of the main coffee machine vendor here in Italy asked us to build some proof of concept to build dashboard for showing data about coffee level and the usage of a coffee machine that can be used in a restaurant or in a bar. So they were not sure about the return on investment. So they, before starting to go in production, so to go in the industrial phase, they asked us to build a proof of concept, and we built a proof of concept in only 2 days of work using WebRatio. So WebRatio is particularly suited to build quick win projects. Going one step further, we also work with proximity technologies. Proximity means to use technologies like NFC beacons to interact with the mobile device of the customers and to show the customer some data that depend on the context. And we use here the proximity experience definition, and we are not talking about proximity marketing, because proximity marketing is about sending messages to users. While we are using IFML to define the proximity experience, so how a customer interacts with the mobile app when it enters a store. So it's not only about showing the customer messages, but it is also about interacting with the mobile app, asking for some question, for example. Where do I find a particular good inside the store? I have to go. I ask help by someone here that can explain me better the details of this product. So with IFML, you can really define without caring about technologies, you can really define the interaction flow. So how you can imagine the user interacting with your store using proximity technologies. And also, we exploit here the code generation engine to build proof of concept. So we are working with some of the major fashion industries here in Italy. We are based in Milan, so it's not difficult to find fashion companies in Milan, and many of them are starting proof of concept of very advanced app that gives a proximity experience to their customers.
And WebRatio brings that instant realization of an idea. So in the sense that when a business has an idea, for them to take it and actually see how it works, it's not an easy task. There's a lot of time lag in between. So with WebRatio, by a simple visual modeling, they can actually see a running code, not just a fancy prototype, but actual running code. That's what you're saying.
Yes, I'm saying exactly this. So not fancy prototypes, but real running code that can be used in production in a few days of work. So this is making the difference, because in this cutting edge domains, so like IoT, but especially proximity, so retail, we are talking about the future of the retail. So here, companies are trying to differentiate, to they fight each other to be the most innovative, the most advanced retail company. And the match is not only about how good is the product, but it's also how good is the experience of the customer, the experience that can be both digital and physical. So companies are really thinking about how they can be very innovative there, and so WebRatio can support them, because it allow them to test immediately the business idea, to translate a business idea in a production in a few days or a few weeks of work. The last topic I will present you today is the mobile payment one. This is another hot topic in these days. This is another topic that can be very easily addressed by WebRatio and IFML, because mobile payment is another kind of interaction. So the user interact with the payment system using a mobile app, for example. And so with IFML, you can define what is the payment process. So instead of having a business process to define the payment process, you use an IFML. And so by using IFML, you can optimize the flow from the moment you choose a product and until the moment of paying, and then you can optimize the flow to maximize the monetization. So and we put inside WebRatio all the kind of mobile technologies, mobile payment technologies, like real-time bank transfer, phone, credit, Apple and Android Pay, credit card, PayPal, and then retail, but also banking institution can use WebRatio for offering their customer mobile payment functionalities. So I end by saying that we are working for supporting what will be the retail in 2020. So we are calling it digital retail 2020. So to support proximity experience, Internet of Things, and mobile payments, we think that this will be the technologies that can allow companies to emerge and compete in the next 5 years.
Fantastic. So basically, in summary, we are saying that this technology can be used to bring an idea to fruition in a very short time, cutting down huge development costs, but also not compromising the quality of the native experience and native expectations. The branding, the digital assets can all be accommodated in the code, and it can be brought to realization in a very short time. So if you can summarize the benefits, and then we can open for QA, that will be great.
Yes, sure. So we can summarize the benefit of using WebRatio both for banking and retail segments. So the first benefit we can show is about lowering development costs. So for example, a typical budget for an application could be 100,000 dollar, and with WebRatio we can address the same application for as less as $25,000. The second benefit I would like to highlight here is that you can start even from uncertain and volatile requirements. So especially if you are working with cutting-edge technologies, you may not have an exactly the idea of how the app will work, how the app will be a very beautiful app. So you can start with a minimum viable product and using WebRatio in a few days of work, you can be in production, and then you can refine by seeing how your customers are using the app. The third benefit is time to market reduction. You can be typically in production. In the average time to market for the first application in our experience is 1 month of work from the first meeting to the being online on the store. And the fourth benefit is the benefits we see for the banking and financial services industry, that is WebRatio allow you to be compliant to regulation, to generate code that is compliant to security rules, and it can be also they can have high performances. And the fifth benefit is that we support cutting edge technologies. So as you saw in the first webinar, by using IFML you are future proof. So you don't have to care about technologies. We do care about technologies, so you have only to think about modeling, and then we do all the rest.
That was good, Stefano. I think we should open for QA, and I just want to add one more point to your benefit slide, is that the client does not have a vendor lock-in of any kind. So since these technologies are all open and you have the source code, you may have a freedom of exiting WebRatio platform in future if you choose to. So there is no kind of binding in the platform itself. I think we should open for QA, and let's see what the audience have to ask.
Yes, thank you, Daniel and Stefano, for this presentation. We have received a number of questions, and now I would like Stefano to answer some of them. Even if we run out of time, Stefano will answer all remaining questions in the follow-up email we are going to send to all participants. So, Stefano, first question is the code generation open for direct changes by the customer, of direct code generation of the platform, or it requires a special customization by the WebRatio company?
Yes, thank you for this question, because it allows me to explain one of the advantages we give with WebRatio, that the code generator is open. So when we train how to use WebRatio, we train how to use modeling, but also how to extend WebRatio. So WebRatio can be extended, and the code generation engine can be changed if you don't like how the code is generated. So the special customization needed to change the code generation can be done autonomously by the customer. Obviously, the customer will need some training, but this is documented. We had a training session both in classroom and online that allow customer to understand how they can change the code generator.
Okay, thank you. Some of our audience is interested also. Oh, sorry, Daniel.
Yeah, go ahead. I was actually going to ask a question myself, but let's answer the audience questions.
Yeah, there interest also in the mobile version. The question is, how the mobile version works with Cordova? Is it a web service framework in order to save mobile resources, or what?
Okay, yes. The Cordova technology is used for generating the client code. As I said before, we are using Cordova as a base code, but then we extended Cordova. We have our own implementation of Cordova. So when you click the generate button, you are generating code that is executed inside a Cordova environment, and this code then is packaged into the package that is ready to be deployed on the store, both the iOS store and the Android store. So this is code that is running on the client side. So you have to understand well the question about web services. The code on client side then can talk with any kind of code on server side. So we support RESTful services, but also old style web services using WSDL. So we support many different kinds of interaction with the web services and the backend in general. So in this case, again, WebRatio is open. So we offer from by default we offer API RESTful API connection and web services connection, but you can easily define your own components that can make a call to any kind of API.
Thank you, Stefano. This was very interesting. Now let's talk about how a company can start using WebRatio. I mean, how do you suggest a company to approach using this kind of tool, and how is it supported the training of the platform?
Yeah, so, sorry to interrupt here. That was exactly what I wanted to actually ask, but I may rephrase it in a way, Stefano, that there are some members in our audience who are actually, you know, representing the banking and retail segment, and they may have some innovation budgets. So suppose they were to propose it to their team that, hey, let's try this out. What should be the roadmap that you suggest? How do they approach WebRatio? What kind of timelines are we looking at? If you can elaborate a little bit on that, some real steps, you know, how do we go about this?
Yes, the typical path to being on board in WebRatio starts from a proof of concept. So we can build a proof of concept in really a few days of work. So 1 day, 2 days, or 5 days is if needed. So we do proof of concept in order to prove the customer how the customer can be fast with WebRatio. And this proof of concept can cover any aspect, so we can build proof of concept for any kind of application, mobile, even the most innovative one, so IoT, proximity, or mobile payment, but also web application. After a proof of concept, we start the typical path includes the development of the real project, so a project that can be delivered by our experts in a few weeks of work. Typically, we see that customers use some member of their team to learn about WebRatio, so to do training on the job. So while some WebRatio expert is building the project, some developer from the customer is doing training on the job on the same project. Then, once the project is done, the application going production, then the typical path is to make a full training session on WebRatio to the customer, covering all the roles that we saw in the first slide today, that is the IFML modeling language, the business process modeling language, the data modeling, the layout and style development, and the integration components. So we have a full training session that lasts 3 weeks that cover all these aspects. Then we offer also online training materials in order to make continuous learning. We continuously update the training library, so to offer new examples, new tutorials. And then we also make an handover of the project, so we transfer to the customer all the models, all the customization, all the layout developed, so that the customer start to manage autonomously the project and the maintenance.
Yeah, I think that was a very clear and necessary explanation, because I know a number of people are thinking that how do we get engaged with WebRatio, and they might want to try it. So what you're saying is they get in touch with you and then work with you for a proof of concept, which may last sometimes 2 to 5 days. And having seen the proof of concept, then you can take it forward, and if they choose to build a project, then your team will work with their team, so there will be a mixed approach, and as you are building, they will learn along the way, and then you will do the knowledge transfer and transition the entire project to them.
Yes, you're right. We do care about all the phases. So the first phase is to, during the POC, is to be sure that the customer can have a measure of the return on investment. So after the objective of the proof of concept is to say to the customer, okay, if you invest in WebRatio technologies, you will have a return, and this is the return. Then the second phase, that is the project, the objective of the project is to go in production. So our commitment there is first go in production, so first build a really solid, beautiful, and successful application. And the second objective is to train on the job. Then the third phase is the knowledge transfer. So here our first commitment is to transfer all possible knowledge about WebRatio for letting the customer to be independent from us. And being independent from us means also being independent from WebRatio platform itself. So it sounds strange, but we really believe in no vendor lock-in. So we are not happy to say customer, okay, you are using WebRatio now, so you will have to use WebRatio forever. So we always want that the customer is free to choose if he wants to use WebRatio platform or not. So during the training session, we also teach how to manage application generated by WebRatio without WebRatio. So this is part of our standard training session that is very important for us to say, okay, we are not locking in our technology. So if you want to continue with WebRatio platform, we are happy and you will have advantages. But if you, at one moment in time, don't feel that you have any more advantages in using WebRatio, you can continue without WebRatio platform.
That is a very nice approach, Stefano. I know a couple of technologies that do have a vendor lock-in, and then you know customers have some hesitancy to take that kind of approach. But this is really open, and I don't see any reason why someone would want to discontinue since the team of WebRatio is also the team which is engaged actively in the cutting-edge development of specifications of the IFML and now IoT and everything. But there could always be a reason why they want to step out, and you are leaving that option open to them. That's great. Any other questions we have, Nicola? Before we close, we have just 1 minute left.
Yeah, we have some other questions, but I think we are out of time, so we will answer all the remaining questions in the follow-up email we are going to send. Now, I just want to remind you and to invite you to join the next session we will have on the 2nd of December, where Daniel will have a live demo for the end-to-end app development on WebRatio. And in this session, Daniel will demonstrate that it's possible to develop 9 times faster a mobile application using WebRatio. So I think this can be very interesting for you in order to understand which is the approach used by the WebRatio platform. And I want just to thank you again, all the speakers and the participants, for joining us today. And I wish to have a nice day.
Thank you, Michaela. And we look forward to seeing our audiences on this webinar number 3 on 2nd December. And these videos are all available on YouTube, on LinkedIn. You can go back and watch them. If you have any more questions, feel free to send emails to Stefano or myself. We have LinkedIn presence. Our email addresses are also published in these videos as well. So please feel free with any questions that you have. We are here to help you. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much.